San Antonio Spurs golf tournament with a box of these exploding golf balls. And we stuck Dennis Scott in a broken elevator with a pregnant lady.
Pretty good. You know they said the bigger they are, the harder they fall. I pretended I was conducting interviews for a network special.
And I pretended I was lobster bisque.
Once they're stuck, Siobhan pretends that she's about to deliver her own diaper dandy.
And here's what happened.
Baby face, you got the cutest little baby face. There's not another one can take your place. Baby face, my poor heart's a jumping cheese. Your start is something. Baby face, a glimpse of heaven when I'm in your fond embrace. I didn't need a shove, cause I just fell in love with your pretty baby face.
Help! We stuck an elevator!
Yeah, it was fun.
I'm falling and I can't get up!
But remember one thing, it's not fun if anybody gets hurt while you're pulling a prank. So be careful out there, please.
Usually you have to audition before becoming a spokesperson. Well, we conducted some screen tests of our own for a drink called Filler Up.
Here's our buddy Chris the bartender with a list of ingredients.
Rick and Charles first asked me to start off with a little tomato juice. Then they said, why don't you add a little pineapple juice? And they said, well, add a little cranberry. And then to top it all off, they said, use a little Tabasco sauce. A lot of Tabasco sauce. Mix it up. And then fill her up.
Dell Curry, take one.
It's a mouthful. It's really full of those fruit flavors that really quenches your thirst.
Cut.
Cut.
How was it?
How's it been?
Yeah.
Kind of spicy.
This stuff stinks, man. Y'all would be the last person caught drinking this.
So you got some hot dog here with you, man?
Right there. A little rice.
Salt bone with this.
Right there. A little
this is the moment we've all been waiting for.
And right there.
We interrupt your regular programming for this Sports Talk Sports exclusive. Rumors have been circulating throughout the NBA of some deals that might be taking place. Well, Sports Talk has verified a big one. Rick Mahorn will become a Charlotte Hornet.
What?
This was learned about 20 minutes ago. But in return, the Hornets will be giving up their number one draft pick from last year from the University of North Carolina, J.R. Reid. That's correct. This rumor has been verified. We have verified it with the front office from Philadelphia as well as Charlotte. J.R. Reid will go to Philadelphia. Rick Mahorn will come to Charlotte.
Oh, man, get out of here.
Top of the
hour. This has been a Sports
Talk. You call my mom, man.
No, that. What?
You call my mom. That'll work.
We had the opportunity to speak with Rick Mahorn at one of our studios in Philadelphia, and he had this reaction when he learned he's coming to the Tar Heel State.
You know, I'm really upset. I feel that the Sixers really got a bad trade right now. I feel that when they get JR, he's a talented player, but he can't hold a line. He can't do the things that I can do. I'm just really disgusted with the whole thing. And what are they going to call a bump and rump now? You know, things like that really upset me.
Who do you think got the best of this trade?
I think Charlotte has the best of the trade because I'm going to Charlotte and I'm going to be a proven player. You don't have to really worry about J.R. Reid because I don't think he's that tough.
You think J.R. will fit in here in Philadelphia?
Only way I think he can fit in is they put a shoehorn and let him get between the lines or something. Let him get through. But right now, I just really can't talk about it too much.
Thanks.
He's pissed off though, man.
But what about Charles Barkley? Take a look at this and see what you think.
I just can't believe it. It's terrible.
He's terrible. You know, Rick is thumping, I'm bumping. I thought we were going to be great together for a few more years. Now they bringing this young kid in. I don't know.
Who do you think got the better end of the deal, the Charlotte Hornets or the Philadelphia 76ers?
Well, I think Charlotte probably, you know, got the better end. They're getting an experienced veteran forward, and we're getting a little kid who's not ready yet.
All right, Charles, we know you're very upset. Thanks for taking the time out to talk to us.
You're welcome. Just a bad, bad trade. Sorry.
So there you have it.
You're in a crowd.
One thing about JR, he don't know that he's on the pro basketball funniest pranks. Hey, buddy, you wonder why all the phones were busy? I gotcha. Back to you, Jerry.
Hey, come on, we were just kidding. Hey, JR, sit down, relax, take it easy, because thanks to Charles Barkley and Rick Mahorn and pro basketball's funniest pranks,
yo,
you've been the latest victim.
One?
And on behalf of everybody, JR, we got you.
Y'all got me. Oh, man, I'm cussing everybody out as far as I'm cussing out the world before I left.